Hot Wheels Unleashed. I just got the game downloaded, so let's check it out. All right, let's open up our first boxes. The first is free. Well, they do look like Hot Wheels. They nailed the look of an actual toy car. Nice. Looks very balanced. I wish I had a little bit more top speed. Oh, that looks more like mine, dude. Top speed, acceleration, handling. The only thing it's missing is braking power. Okay, I'm calling it right now. That's overpowered. We're basically sacrificing braking power to turn up every other stat. Yeah, we don't need brakes to just slow us down. And a car that looks... actually has a lot of boost. It really comes down to how important boost is going to be for lap times. Hard? Extreme? Should I start with extreme? International. Oh, first thing we're gonna need to test out if you can make a boost start. Failed. I might have been too early, I'm not sure. Okay, I found the boost button. Okay, we can roll too, got it. Oh, that's like the magnetic on the wall driving that you might know from Mario Kart. Okay, you can mess with them. I mean, the Camaro is a balanced car. And considering you're not really losing too much speed, I think going for a top speed car should work out just fine. Ah, wow, that looks so much better than my entire apartment. Okay, so you got your space where you can put your cars. That's cool. Oh, we're actually racing through our basement. I assume if you customize a basement, it's also gonna change on the track. Options. Yeah. Let's turn it down to hard. Extreme might have been a bit too much. Okay, it's looking a lot better. You know, maybe for extreme you need some better cars. Hot Wheels, obviously. Okay, that works. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! So close. I got my coins, I got blind box. Yeah, by the way, somebody asked, there shouldn't be any microtransactions in this game. You just open the boxes in the game with in-game currency. Yeah, I still have to find out like the... wait, is that a duplicate? I have a duplicate! No! I can dismantle it though. I can dismantle it because it is a duplicate. Ah, burr. That's what they call Hot Wheels. I see, so if you get duplicates, you're gonna get cogwheels and you use those to upgrade your cars. Got it. One thing I wish the game had would be a speedo. I feel like every racing game needs a speedo. It doesn't matter if it's Hot Wheels, Mario Kart, or Need for Speed. Every racing game needs a speedo. Hey, so far I'm liking it a lot more than I thought I would. Quick match, let's see. Jumping in the multiplayer. Lobby found! Hey, there you go. Oh, people are playing. What's that? Oh, okay! Definitely one of the more advanced levels. Holy moly. Hey, we got one. Oh, ice, no! Gotta say, now that we are driving on some more hardcore tracks, this is way more fun. Oh, that's second place! Let's go! No! Let me boost! Let me boost again! Okay, we got him! Hey! Okay, so multiplayer is working and it seems pretty populated too, so nice. But I kinda wanna see more of the story stuff. Another balanced, we have a Ford Mustang GT. You can make your own liveries. Ah, cool. But to be fair, I just wanna race. So the fear that I had is that, you know, the tracks might be boring. And that is not true. Like, my initial feel about the game was kind of low because they didn't really show very cool tracks. The game's actually surprisingly a lot better than I thought. I like it. I feel like until you learn the tracks, medium is a good difficulty. It allows you to make a mistake and still get first place so you can actually progress through the game. Extreme, I think you need a fully upgraded car. I honestly think for extreme, you're not gonna be making it with a starter car. Oh, that actually helps you around the corner. Oh, I like this. Oh, I'm waiting for custom tracks that are gonna be super fast. Honestly, the track design is so much better than what I expected it to be. So, we get 100 coins, 100 gears, and we get a blind box. We unlock the Nitro Bot, Basement Customization, Ctrl-Alt-Delete. Track Builder Module, the Nitro Bot. Hey guys, Sakura here. Check out Instant Gaming for cheap game keys. Click the link in the description below. Yeah, if you get it on Instant Gaming and it's 25 bucks, that is super reasonable. I totally agree. Let me go! It's like a childhood dream come true. That is something I heard very many times. Honestly, this is a really well-made game. I didn't expect it to be as high of a quality. I mean, it even has unlocked frame rate on the PC. Yeah, I think you have to fake the spider. No! That didn't work at all. Oh, it's actually a random layout. Wow! The spider has some good AI. Some really good AI. Ooh, I can upgrade it. I'll get an extra boost bar and even more speed. Ha ha ha, yes. Fine work. Is it maxed out? Ooh, legendary! Hey, hey! We got our first legendary. 24 hours. I don't know if that's really worth investing right now. I mean, at some point you're gonna get your missing ones. The missing ones in the limited shop here. Checkpoint missed, okay. Okay, you gotta be so freaking careful with where you boost on this particular map. It will easily shoot you out. Man, that's really cool physics. But it doesn't really happen that often. You know, you can use your right analog stick to rebalance your car, but I wasn't ready. So there are a lot of different boost types. This one is interesting because it's dynamic. Ah, not in the last lap again! I think my tip would be to not boost before the spider. If you boost before the spider shoots faster. It makes it so much harder to evade. Yeah, okay. I think I finally figured out the spider. If you boost, spider is fast. If you don't boost, spider is slow. So you wait for the spider to shoot and then you boost. You can fly past the spider, there's a jump. Yeah, like one thing that I will definitely still have to find is like all the shortcuts. How's the handling feel? Sometimes I lose the drift and it's not as easily adjustable as I would like it to be, but that might be on purpose. Ah, shit, shit, shit. Too fast. Ooh, there's a rare car. It's another one of those. Look at this, man. It has everything with braking power. That is so overpowered. I feel like it handles a little bit better than the Sonic car that I had earlier. Can open up your blind boxes. I just bought one! Man, the default option is buying one. Oh man. What did we get? We got the Skull Crusher. Alright. That was worth it, I guess. The Supercharged. No microtransactions, by the way. Uber Eats. Now, what is this? Hot Fuels Quick Eats. Okay. I can also sell it. How much is it? I have no idea how much I just got. Will the game tell me? Shit. How much did I sell it for? 300? Okay, that's actually not bad, because that's like nearly a new crate. You sell two cars, you get a new crate. Like, you trade in two cars, you get a new one. It makes sense for your doubles. Or, what's even better in my opinion, is dismantling them and use those cog wheels to actually upgrade your car. Because I like made my thing legendary. Box, box, box. Ooh, the twin mill! Hell yeah. That's a common? Really? The twin mill is a common. And the Fiat 500. Somebody wanted that earlier. Now that is a common car, okay? That one is common. Alright, I had enough. I'm tired. 10 hours. So thanks so much for watching. Sleep tight. Definitely come back tomorrow for more. And good night.